Everyone, hi, good evening, and welcome to Grade Up. So here I am, Cyril, with you today with this second session on DI of Z. We have already discussed about Z 2019 and 2020 in our previous session. So today it is the turn of 2017 and 18 papers. I hope I am audible and visible to you. Just confirm once. After that, I'll start with the session. Hello. Yeah, hi, hello. Hello, Siddhant. How are you? Good evening, guys. We'll start in just another minute by the time some other people join in. So let's wait for a few more guys and then we'll start. Hi, Ankit Solanki. Hello. Good evening. So it's just, I think, after this Sunday, the next Sunday would be Z, right? ये भी नजदीक आ गया. And with Z, it feels like this year's exam season is over then. Because CAT and Z are the biggest exams. Then SNAP and IFT are the other two only which are left. We already have had SNAP. This time SNAP is also happening in two slots. Hi, Chandan. Hello. चलिए, सो आई थिंक वी शुड स्टार्ट नाउ, है ना? स्टार्ट कर देते हैं. हाय काजल चौधरी, यू आर नॉट इन सीएल एनीमोर. नो काजल, नो, आई एम नॉट देयर. आई एम विद ग्रेड अप नाउ. इट्स बीन लॉन्ग. हाय, गुड इवनिंग अभिषेक. गुड इवनिंग. ओ, थैंक यू वेरी मच अंकित. आई मीन दीज स्टेटमेंट्स आर डेफिनेटली अ मोरल बूस्टर फॉर पीपल लाइक अस. आई मीन व्हाट बेस्ट कैन बी फॉर ए टीचर दैट ए स्टूडेंट फील्स गुड अबाउट हिज टीचिंग्स. हाय बितिका, गुड इवनिंग. हाय शिवांग अग्रवाल, गुड इवनिंग. सो काजल, आई होप यू आर द सेम पर्सन फ्रॉम गार्गीज बैच, राइट? इन द बैच वेयर गार्गी वॉज ऑल्सो देयर. हाय जतन साहू, गुड इवनिंग. चलिए जी, सो आई थिंक वी शुड स्टार्ट नाउ. वी हैव एनफ पीपल हु हैव कम टू अटेंड दिस सेशन एंड आई एम श्योर दैट ऑल ऑफ यू वुड हैव डन दिस फर्स्ट सेशन एज वेल ऑन डी आई विच वी टुक यस्टरडे. सो पर डी आई पे वी आर हैविंग ओनली टू सेशंस, दो वी हैड फाइव सेशंस ऑन क्वांटिटेटिव एप्टीट्यूड एंड आई गॉट ए फीडबैक फ्रॉम दोज फाइव सेशंस दैट स्टूडेंट्स एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड फीलिंग कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट क्वांटिटेटिव एबिलिटी आफ्टर अटेंडिंग दोज सेशंस बिकॉज वी जस्ट टुक आउट द इजियर क्वेश्चंस एंड इवन आई फेल्ट दिस दैट आई हैव एन ऑल्सो नेवर फाउंड द क्वेश्चंस टू बी दिस इजी इन दैट बट इन दोज सेशंस आई फिगर आउट दैट येस सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस आर एक्सट्रीमली ईजी एक्चुअली दो जेट इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी स्लाइटली ऑन द डिफिकल्ट साइड. सो नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग डी आई. सो दो वी डू नॉट हैव मेनी डी आई क्वेश्चन इन जेट, ओनली टू सेट्स, राइट? एंड दोज टू सेट्स मीन सिक्स क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज जनरली वॉट हैपन्स इन डी आई, राइट? सो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट 19 एंड 20 येस्टरडे. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 17 एंड 18 टूडे, राइट? लेट्स स्टार्ट देन. हाई गुड इवनिंग शिवम, लुकिंग गुड. ओ थैंक यू वेरी मच. आई मीन दो इट इज डेफिनेटली अप्रिशिएबल. चलिए जी, सो शुरू करते हैं. हाँ जी, हेयर इट इज. सो फर्स्ट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट कैट 2000, सॉरी जेट 2018, राइट? सो द क्वालिटी वुड बी स्लाइटली बैड बिकॉज आई हैव स्ट्रेट अवे टेकन इट फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन पेपर इटसेल्फ. सो द क्वेश्चन पेपर वॉज अवेलेबल सो आई जस्ट टुक ए पिक्चर ऑफ दैट एंड आई पुट इट हियर, राइट? बट आई वुड डेफिनेटली लाइक टू डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन विद ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर वन सिंगल रीजन. दो जनरली वी फील दीज क्वेश्चन आर डिफिकल्ट एंड वी नोट ट्राई दीज क्वेश्चन इन द एग्जाम. वी डोंट ट्राई, राइट? बट आई मीन वंस यू स्टार्ट फीलिंग कंफर्टेबल विद दिस आई थिंक यू कैन डू दीज क्वेश्चन वेरी इजिली. सो आई थॉट आई शुड डिस्कस दिस. एटलीस्ट यू विल गेट सम कॉन्फिडेंस दैट येस दीज क्वेश्चन कैन बी डन इजिली. So it's not that they are going to take a lot of time or we won't be able to do such set, because I remember some of the students doing this, that sir, whenever I look at such a set, I feel that I probably would not be able to do it. So many students tell me this. So I thought it's a question based upon tournaments. So I should discuss it. Probably it will give you confidence that you can do it, right? Let's start doing it. This is from Z 2018, guys, right? 19 and 20 we have already done. It is 2018, and after this we'll be discussing 2017 as well, right? Hi Pintu, good evening, and Sudarshan, good evening. Okay, your first class, that's great. चलिए जी, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस नाउ. हाँ जी, सो इट सेज सिक्स टीम्स आर प्लेइंग इन अ हॉकी टूर्नामेंट वेयर ईच टीम इज प्लेइंग अगेंस्ट एवरी अदर टीम एग्जैक्टली वंस एट एन इंटरमीडिएट स्टेज. द स्टेटस इज एज फॉलो. सो दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. दो ईच टीम प्लेज अगेंस्ट एवरी अदर टीम एग्जैक्टली वंस, बट दिस इज द टेबल एट एन इंटरमीडिएट स्टेज. दैट मीन्स स्टिल नाउ वी डिड नॉट हैव मैचेस बिटवीन ऑल ऑफ देम, राइट? इट इज एन इंटरमीडिएट स्टेज, देर इज वन पर्टिकुलर स्टेज. अदरवाइज हैड ईच टीम प्लेड अगेंस्ट एवरी अदर टीम, देर वुड हैव बीन फाइव मैचेस फॉर ईच टीम. देर आर सिक्स टीम्स, सो वन टीम वुड हैव प्लेड फाइव मैचेस, राइट? टीम ए विल प्ले अगेंस्ट बी सी डी ई एफ, बी विल प्ले अगेंस्ट ए सी डी ई एफ. तो ऐसा होना चाहिए था, बट दे हैव प्लेड ओनली टू मैचेस. Each of them have played only two matches. That means it's an intermediate stage. This is what we are talking about, right? Okay. Next, what else is given? Number of matches played by them, number of matches won by them, number of matches lost, drawn, goals scored by the team, goals conceded by the team. The point is that how do we represent the data? How do we make out that who would be playing against whom? What is the score line? How would I write it? So I generally represent it like this. So let us say there is a match between B and C. So I would write like this if B is winning the match. If C is winning the match, I would write CB like this. So basically, this is my way. You can also adopt it if it suits you, that I write the name of the winner first. And then I write the name of the loser, right? Let us say B is winning by 3-0 against C. Let us assume. So I would straight away go to B. Goals scored by him are 3 against C and 0 against, 3 in favor of B and 0 against C. So goals scored by the team, goals conceded by the team. So three goals were done by B, right, on C, and 0 was done by C on B. And when 3-0 is written as a score line of B, for C the score line would become 0-3. If B is 3-0, for C it would be 0-3, because if B is doing 3 and B has conceded 0, that means C has done 0 and they have conceded 3. So, जो यहां पे इट विल बी रिटन एज 3-0, ऑन द अदर साइड इट वुड बी रिटन एज 0-3. दिस इज वॉट वी आर डूइंग हियर. आई होप दिस इज अंडरस्टूड. अरविंद हैज अ क्वेश्चन इन मॉक्स आई एम स्कोरिंग, वेलकम टू दैट अरविंद, राइट? सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद इट. एंड वॉट इज द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट? द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट आई ऑलवेज सी, ए हैज नॉट लॉस्ट ए मैच, बी हैज नॉट लॉस्ट ए मैच, दे हैव ड्रॉन वन, सी हैव ड्रॉन वन, डी हैज नॉट लॉस्ट ए मैच, दे हैव ड्रॉन टू, बोथ ऑफ देम. And E did not win a match, they lose both the matches, and F also lose both the matches. The important point here is, look at these figures, guys. If I count the number of draws, keep this in mind always, this is a good hint for you. The total number of draws must be even. The total number of draws must be even. Rather, I should say, the sum of all the figures in the column of draws should be even. So when I add them, that gives me 4. Why should it be even? Because whenever there is a match which is drawn, if there is a match which is drawn, so obviously it would be counted in the draw of both of them. If A and B drew a match, for A we'll say they drew a match, for B also we'll say they drew a match. So in the number of draws for A, 1 would be written, the number of draws for B, 1 would be written. So therefore the total would be 1 plus 1, 2, right? Similarly here, I see the total is 4. If the total is 4, that means actually the number of draw matches must be half of 4, that is 2. If the column adds up to 4, that means the number of draws is equal to 2, because this 4 is actually coming from adding all those numbers in draws. So when A and B drew, तो हमने A भी add किया, B भी add किया. So ultimately we actually added a batch twice. C and D had a draw, so we added C, A, we added D as well. So again we added twice. Because of that, this column comes out to be total as 4. I mean, it's an even number, and therefore it comes out to be double of the number of draws. I hope this part is clear. Hi Sonu Khan, hello, good evening. Yes, I hope this is clear. I'm not seeing any message on the YouTube channel by any guys now. Shivang ke baad no one has responded. I'm assuming that all of you got the concept till this point. Then we'll move forward. Next, the number of matches won. Can I say whenever a team wins, obviously someone else loses. So therefore, this total should be equal to this total. The number of matches won should be equal to the number of matches lost. I'm telling you this thing because these questions might appear with some missing figures as well. So there it might be helpful for you. Ki total number of draws even banne chahiye. Number of matches won plus number of matches lost should be equal all the times. These are some small hints with which we start. We always start with that. Okay. So Karan Rana says yes. So I see Karan on YouTube now. Omraj says clear, Shivam says clear, hi Zahara, Abhishek says clear, Bithika clear and Siddharth is also clear. तो चलिए फिर यहाँ से आगे बढ़ते हैं हम लोग, next पे आते हैं. So Shivam is also saying it is clear and Kajal Chaudhary is also saying yes, it's clear. Okay, move forward. Now when I see that the number of draws is only 2, so there are 2 draws. If there are 2 draws, and D also had 2 draws. So both the draws are there with D for sure. Is that right? And which teams had a draw? One is B and one is C. So D and B had a draw. D and C had a draw. There is no other possibility through which they can have a draw. Right? D and B will have a draw. And D and C will have a draw. Usse kya hoga? The number of draws that is complete now. This column is complete. Understood? Total number of 4 draws were there. So obviously B is having 2 draws. So one draw with C and one draw with E. Alok says in decision making DI comes. Yeah, it was there in 2018 in one of, yes, in 2018 itself it was there. Generally it is not there otherwise. Okay ji, so let's move ahead. Isse aage badhte hain. So D and B had a draw, D and C had a draw. So what are the score lines? Let's look at this. If you talk about D guys, look at D. D has done one goal and they have conceded one. Both the matches of a team are draws. They have done one goal, they have conceded one goal. So can I say, in one of the matches they must have drawn by 1-1. In the other match they must have drawn by 0-0. Is there any other possibility which is possible? I mean, had the score been 1-0 in one, they would have won. Had the score been 0-1 in one, they would have lost. So if they are drawing both the matches, definitely in one of the matches, the score line would be 1-1. That means they did one goal. The other team also did one goal. In one of them, it should be 0-0. Neither they did any goal, nor the other team did any goal. These two must be the score lines for them, right? Now, they have drawn with B and C. The next thing is, if you look at C guys, they have drawn a match, but they have not conceded any goal. No one has done a goal against C. So can I say the score line of D and C, it cannot be 1-1, it has to be 0-0 and it must be 1-1 for DB. When C has not been able to concede any goal, sorry, no team has done any goal against C, so 1-1 is not possible. Because 1-1 means you did a goal, they also did a goal. So 0 ke case mein, how is that possible? So therefore, we cannot do that. Right? Shivam is saying we can also make table and proceed. You can do that. Many people do that. I find it a bit confusing. Writing ABCD on the top, ABCD on this line, and then writing the score lines there. Mujhe thoda difficult lagta. I avoid that. If you find it comfortable, you can definitely go ahead with that. There is no, you can say, right way of doing things. Every person has their own way of doing questions, so that doesn't make a problem. So, Z is a bit tougher. That's right. But Bharat, if you actually look at the questions, you would not find that they are not difficult. Kajal says, no, sir, why 10 and 10? Why 10 and 10? I did get your point, Kajal. I have not taken 10. So, yes, it would be current. It would be 11 questions means you'll clear the cutoff. But we'll take up such questions afterwards after doing this set. So I hope this is clear to all of you now that 1-1 and 0-0, right? So now team D is completely over. Their quota is completely over. The point is now if I talk about team C. Team C has drawn one match and we just saw that they have drawn this with 0-0. So that means still they have to do these two goals and still they have to concede zero goals. टू गोल्स उनको अभी भी करने हैं अगेंस्ट सम टीम वी डोंट नो बट दे हैव टू डू टू गोल्स येट राइट सो इन दैट रिमेनिंग मैच ऑफ सी कैन आई से सी इज गोइंग टू विन एंड दे आर गोइंग टू विन बाय 2-0 अगेंस्ट हुम वी डोंट नो वी कैन श्योरली से दे कैन नॉट विन अगेंस्ट ए बिकॉज ए हैज नॉट लॉस्ट ए मैच They cannot win against B because B has not lost a match. So they must have won either against A or against F. Either against A or against F. I hope that is clear now. Understood? So Shayan says 2-0-0-0. That's absolutely correct, Shayan. You are right that way. Kajal Chaudhary 1-1 and 1-1. Kajal, they have done total one goal. If both the matches are 1-1-1-1, that means they must have done two goals and against them there should also be two goals. But wo to ho nahi payega na fir. Divyansh, I am deliberately skipping your question right now because let's talk about this set. So at the end, I'll take up your questions. So let's move forward, guys. Aage badhte hain usse. So now that was about C. Let us talk about B as well. B has drawn a goal by 1-1. So if they have drawn by 1-1, so now there are no more goals against them, but still they have done four more goals, right? They have done four more goals. Is that correct? Team B must have won their remaining match by 4-0. So B must have won by 4-0 in their remaining match. As I told you, 5-1 is there. They drew by 1-1. 5 और 1 में से 1-1 सबट्रैक्ट कर दीजिए रिमेनिंग इज 4-0 दैट मींस इन द अदर मैच दे विनिंग बाय 4-0 सी शुड विन मैच अगेंस्ट ई और ए सर ज़ाहरा सी कैन नॉट विन अगेंस्ट ए हैज नॉट लॉस्ट ए मैच सो हाउ कैन सी विन अगेंस्ट ए सो इट विल बी ओनली ई और एफ राइट इट विल बी ओनली ई और एफ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस नाउ नाउ द पॉइंट इज Team B has won a match against, by 4-0. And we know that they would have won either against E or against F. The point is, now listen to this carefully. Let us say they won against E. Let us say they won against E. So the score line of 4-0 for E would become 0-4. Right? For E it is 0-4. B did 4 goals on E. And they conceded 0. So on for E, it would be opposite. That E conceded 4, right? B did 4 on them. And they did not do any good. So now after taking out this 0 and 4, what are we left with? For E, the other score line should be 1-0 then. By E had 4 goals against them. All 4s have been done by B now. So obviously in the remaining match, they are not going to concede any goal. If they are not going to concede any goal, how are they going to lose that second match? Right? If B plays against E, E would not be able to lose the other match. Because by 4-0, they will lose in one for the other one the score has to be 1-0. So the only possibility is that B must have won against F. Right? Yes, Siddharth, as I am saying, B can be with F. Rather, now we can prove that B will be with F. This is the way through which we go, I mean, in these questions. So basically, this assumption was wrong. And I would say that B won against F, right? So ye sab main yahan se hata deta hun. And if B won against F by how much? 4-0. That means the other match F has lost by 0-3. Because 7 mein se 4 is taken out. 0 mein se 0 is taken out. So they must have lost the other match by 0-3. And obviously they cannot lose the match by 0-3 to C. Because C to won by 2-0. So C must have won against E. C won against E by 2-0. So for the other match, what are the possibilities for C now? C ke liye yahan reh jayega 1 aur yahan reh jayega 2. Now this 3-0 and 2-1 are the matches that A must have played against E and F. So A and E had a match. A and F had a match. A or E ka score line would be how much? 2-1. Or A or F ka score line would be 3-0. Now with this score line, you will find that every match complete table is satisfied. Who played against whom? What is the score line? Everything you are getting it now. So first of all, you pay attention to the draws. Then you pay attention to number of wins. Should be equal to the number of loss. And then you start with the draws. Here we started with draws. If there are no draws, you can start with any other number. Normally, you should start with the numbers which are smallest. Right? When I say team A, they did 5 goals and they conceded 1. They won 2 matches. There are many possibilities. If a team has done 5 matches and they have conceded 1, there are many ways. Probably they won 1 by 2-1, the other one by 3-0. Probably they won 1 by 3-1, the other one by 2-0. Or 4-1 and 1-0. Both possibilities ho jati hain. But suppose a team has won both matches and they have done only 2 goals and conceded 0. So obviously they must have won 1 by 1-0, the other 1 by 1-0. Or possibility nahi hai. Right? 2-0 ke case mein. So when you start with the smaller numbers, the number of possibilities is less. And that will give you the set. Okay? So here we have got the complete data now. So now just look at the questions. Which of the following matches are yet to be played? Let's look at them one by one. Which of the matches is yet to be played? So, what all matches did we have till now? DBD, I mean, you will do it by yourself now, hai na? Theek hai, I see that all of them, I remember the answer. I think this is the answer. Because AB and EF, they have not yet played any match. You can see it here. There is no match between EF. There is no match between AB. So, therefore, we can straight away say that AB and EF are yet to play a match, right? वैसे भी we could have said this just by looking at, I mean without doing anything. Can there be a match between EF yet? No, they both lost 2 matches. So if there was a match between E and F, someone would have won, na? E did not win a match, F did not win a match. So how can E and F have a match? They both are losing their matches. Right? Similarly, if I talk about A and B, B won one match, they cannot win against A, A did not lose. They draw one match, A has no draws. So again, I can surely say A and B has no draws. So without doing anything, just by looking at the table, you can say that this match is still not possible. Nahi hua hai. Right? Similarly, the other questions now, I think we have got the complete thing. Toh phir aap dekh ke bata doge inme se kaun sa correct hai. Just go to that table and then you can answer it. Right? So, wo ab kar lijiyega. Usme main nahi jaunga. That's not important. Wo to uske baad to sirf answer type karne hain. Let's come to this part now. Question number. This was the second set. So, that was the first set in Z. 2018 I am talking about. This was the second set in Z. Again in 2018, and there was one more set in Z 2018 that was more of LRDI, but it was placed under decision making section. I mean, you can go through Z 2018 paper, you will find it out there. There was a set in which some of the train schedules were given to us, that this train leaves from this station at this time, it reaches these all stations at this time, there is a courier person, he has to go somewhere and he has to do this, so on and so forth, something like this. शयान इज सेइंग ये डरावना सेट है. जतन सेज नॉट विजिबल क्लियरली, सो शयान हैज गिवन द आंसर ऑफ जतन क्वेश्चन. सो इट इज नॉट विजिबल जतन ओनली बिकॉज इट इज डरावना. सो बिकॉज इट वॉज स्केरी, सो देयर फॉर आई चोज ए पिक्चर सो दैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू लुक एट इट केयरफुली, अदरवाइज ज्यादा डर लगेगा मेरे ख्याल से. सो इसीलिए हम लोगों ने इसको ऐसा रख लिया. खैर एनी वेज, द डेटा वॉज टू लॉन्ग, राइट? सो जारा, आई नो द डेटा इज नॉट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू, एंड इफ यू आर डूइंग इट फ्रॉम द मोबाइल इट विल बी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू, बट देर वॉज अ लॉन्ग चार्ट एंड आई कुड नॉट प्लेस इट सम हाउ एनी वेयर एल्स, सो आई हैव टू मेक इट कंप्लीटली. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डू दिस, बट आई विल जस्ट गिव यू एन आइडिया अबाउट दिस. लेट मी जस्ट रीड इट फॉर यू कि कहे क्या रहा ये. सो वॉट इज रिटन अबव, द ग्राफ बिलो रिप्रेजेंट द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ फोर प्रोफेसर्स अक्रॉस ईयर्स मेजर्ड ऑन फोर वेरिएबल्स: परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन टीचिंग, परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन रिसर्च, फीडबैक ऑन ए स्केल ऑफ 10, एंड नंबर ऑफ पब्लिकेशंस ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड. अज्यूम दैट द क्यूमुलेटेड टाइम स्पेंट पर ईयर ऑन रिसर्च एंड टीचिंग एक्टिविटीज आर सेम फॉर ऑल फोर प्रोफेसर्स एंड ईच ऑफ देम टॉट ओनली वन कोर्स ऑफ 90 क्लासरूम आवर्स. सो ही इज सेइंग दिस लाइन इज टेलिंग यू अबाउट द टीचिंग आवर्स ऑफ ए प्रोफेसर, दिस लाइन इज टेलिंग यू अबाउट द रिसर्च आर, रादर परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन टीचिंग एंड परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन रिसर्च. परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन रीचिंग, ओ नो नो नो, आई एम सॉरी गाइस, सॉरी. ही सेज दिस पोर्शन इज टेलिंग यू द परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन टीचिंग एंड दिस इज द परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन रिसर्च. इट्स ए क्यूमुलेटिव बार ग्राफ, राइट? सो फॉर द फर्स्ट प्रोफेसर यू कैन से 90% टाइम इज स्पेंट ऑन टीचिंग एंड ओनली 10% इज स्पेंट ऑन रिसर्च, राइट? फॉर द सेकेंड पर्सन इट इज लाइक 75% एंड 25%, सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. दिस लाइन इज टेलिंग यू अबाउट द फीडबैक ऑफ दैट टीचर ऑन ए स्केल ऑफ 10, एंड दिस टाइम यू विल हैव टू लुक एट द राइट स्केल, एंड दिस इज टेलिंग यू अबाउट द नंबर ऑफ पब्लिकेशंस ऑफ द टीचर. फॉर दैट ऑल्सो यू हैव टू रेफर टू द राइट स्केल. सो फॉर द बार्स यू हैव टू रेफर टू द लेफ्ट स्केल, फॉर द लाइन्स यू हैव टू रेफर टू द राइट स्केल. बार्स आर टेलिंग यू अबाउट द परसेंटेज ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन टीचिंग एंड रिसर्च, लाइन्स आर टेलिंग यू अबाउट हिज फीडबैक एंड नंबर ऑफ पब्लिकेशंस, राइट? सो फॉर फोर प्रोफेसर्स दे हैव गिवन ऑल द डेटा टू यू, ठीक? सो ऑब्वियसली जस्ट बाय लुकिंग एट दिस ग्राफ यू विल फील दैट आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डू दिस, एज सिंपल एज दिस, ठीक है? बट एज वी हैव डिस्कस बिफोर एज वेल इन दैट यू हैव टाइम, डू नॉट डू दिस इन दैट. ऑलवेज ट्राई वन और टू क्वेश्चन, पॉसिबली क्वेश्चन कैन बी ईजी. आई एम टेलिंग यू सिंस दोज क्यूए सेक्शन ऑफ दैट वेन वी डिस्कस्ड इट आई टोल्ड यू कि भैया क्यूए में भी इफ द क्वेश्चन इज लेंथी डू नॉट लीव द क्वेश्चन, यू हैव एम्पल टाइम इन दैट. सो जस्ट रीड इट वंस एंड इफ यू फाइंड इट ईजी ट्राई इट, इफ यू फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट लीव इट, ठीक है? ऐसा कर सकते हो, बट हियर यू हैव टाइम, यू कैन डू दिस. यस स्तुति चौहान, आई हैव बीन टेलिंग दिस इन एवरी क्लास, डू द प्रीवियस ईयर जेड पेपर्स ऑफ लास्ट 10 ईयर्स, देन बी सफिशियंट फॉर यू टू प्रिपेयर. ओके एवरीवन, आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. सो लेट्स लुक एट द क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस, ठीक है? एक क्वेश्चन करके देखते हैं इसके ऊपर. व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन? काउंट द नंबर ऑफ इंस्टेंसेस इन विच एनुअल डिक्रीजिंग एफर्ट्स इन रिसर्च, दैट मीन्स रिसर्च का गो डाउन, is accompanied with annual increase in feedback. So feedback should go up, research should go down, and feedback should go up. How many such instances are there? Let's check this. Okay. So once let's do this. What is research? Research is this portion, right? This portion, this portion. He says research should go down and feedback should go up. When does this occur? So research goes down from here to here, but feedback does not go up. And yes, this is the first instance. The green one is the first instance. This is the second instance. Research goes down, feedback goes up. And then research goes down, feedback goes up. Third instance, research goes down, feedback goes up. Fourth instance. And then we have fifth instance. And here we have sixth instance. Then we have seventh instance, and then we have eighth instance, and ninth instance, and that's all. So 9 is the answer. I mean, this question did not require any specific kind of knowledge. We just have to look at this and we had to answer the questions. Now, probably I can say this set was not that difficult because actually he did not ask us anything in terms of percentages. He just asked us that research should decrease, feedback should increase, and if I have one such question, I have done one such question, I would definitely try other one. I think you will also do that. After looking at this question, if you are able to do it, you will think, yeah, ठीक है यार, एक और try कर लेते हैं. If the question is this easy, what is the harm in trying? तो कर सकते हैं. So you will try the other one as well, right? What is the other one, by the way? Which of the following shows the maximum year-to-year percentage growth in feedback? So can't we just go by these four options and check? Oh, none of these is also there. That means we have to find out year-to-year maximum percentage growth in feedback. ठीक है? Though that would not be difficult, guys. Trust me. Feedback में year-on-year maximum percentage growth. So year-on-year maximum percentage growth. If I look at feedback here, यहाँ पे, so this is actually 4 and this is approximately 6.5. 4 से 6.5 is around 60+%, right? And this is अगला ग्रोथ यहाँ पे है. This is 5 से 8, 60%. So then I can see कि ग्रोथ यहाँ पे और मैक्सिमम ग्रोथ देखो यहाँ दिख सकता है. There are just few options where you can find maximum growth. Here it is possible. Here it is possible. I mean, on a smaller base, there has to be a larger increase. So there are not many options. So there are just 4 or 5 values. Just check them. You'll get an answer by that. Okay. So somehow by doing this, it feels like that the question was not that difficult. But yes, out of the two sets, I have always felt that one set is always doable in Z. DI का वन सेट इज ऑलवेज डूएबल. सो इधर यू डू दिस सेट ऑफ द प्रीवियस वन. बाय द वे, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट जेट 2018 विच इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी टफर देन अदर एग्जाम्स, अदर जेट्स. ठीक है? सो ये थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट आया था. एंड दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन एग्जाम. दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन एग्जाम. आई रिमेंबर देर वॉज अ आई मीन आई अपियर्ड फॉर दिस एग्जाम. सो आई रिमेंबर देर वॉज अ ग्रेट डिफिकल्टी वाइल डूइंग दिस क्वेश्चन. द रीजन इज देर वर 4 ग्राफ्स. सो एवरी टाइम यू हैव टू स्क्रोल डाउन, स्क्रोल अप, स्क्रोल डाउन एंड स्क्रोल अप. दैट्स अ बिग प्रॉब्लम. मोर ओवर द काइंड ऑफ सिस्टम दैट वी गेट, द डेस्कटॉप दैट वी गेट इन दीज सेंटर्स. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू नो द सिचुएशन. यू मस्ट हैव रिटन कैट, मस्ट हैव गॉन थ्रू दिस, दैट द सिचुएशन इज वेरी बैड ना. Okay, so let's move forward from this. I'll come to this set now. Question number 7 to 10. This was Z 2017. So I'll ask you that do not take DI of Z 2017 or years before that too seriously. It does not mean they are not important. They are important. But some of those sets from 2017 or before are such that they were more suited for a paper-based exam only. Till 2017, that was a paper-based exam. So some of those were like this, that they could have been done better only on a paper-based exam. But when it becomes an online exam, doing them would be very difficult. So this first set, if I show it to you, you might have an off mood for the remaining day. Okay? You might not get a good sleep. That, oh, this kind of set appears in Z. So you might get suicidal thoughts as well. So this is the kind of set that we have from Z 2017 here. So just hold your breath. I'll show you the set. But yes, just keep one thing in mind, that this is one that kind of set which we are not going to do. This is one of those kind of things whose, I mean, generally we say that you can't say anything from the looks of a person. ठीक है? So even if a person is not very good looking, he can be a very nice guy. I mean, I'm an example of that. But still, the point is sometimes the people are so bad looking or ugly looking that you can say, even if he's a nice guy, I'm not going to talk to him. So this is one of those sets. Let me just show it to you. So hold your breath and just look at this now. So I mean, first of all, the information itself. The grid below captures relationships among 7 personality diamonds: extraversion, true arousal, plaque, true arousal, calf, so on and so forth. We have never heard of these personality dimensions in any person ever. The diagonal represents the histograms of the seven dimensions. What exactly is this histogram? We studied it in school time, but don't remember it now. Left of the diagonal represents scatter plots between the dimensions, while the right of the diagonal represents quantitative relationship between the dimensions. The lines and the scatter plots are closest approximation of the points. The value of the relationship to the right of the diagonal can vary from minus 1 to 1, with minus 1 being extreme linear negative and plus 1 extreme linear positive relation. So here comes the set, right? Here comes the set. Hold your breath, guys, and here it is. Now tell me, how does it look? Good, bad, love at first sight, something of that sort. So this was the data which was given to us, and there were some questions which were asked on this. I mean, if you ask me, the moment I look at this, okay, if I have a mobile, I'll take a picture and I'll move forward. If I do not have a mobile, this was a paper based exam, I'll just put a cross, I'll try to stick those pages together on which this graph is there, so that somehow it should not come in front of my eyes even when I'm looking through the questions. You know, this is that kind of graph. No one is going to do this question. No one is going to do this question, right? But I mean, when I appeared for it, I had to do it, so I tried it. Okay? Look at the first question. Which of the following is true? Which of the following is true? Extraversion has two modes. Everyone knows what is a mode. Okay? Mode is the value that occurs maximum number of times. Extraversion. Here is extraversion. He says it is two modes. Extraversion is having two modes. Yes, there are two modes. That's correct. Question was asking which of the following is true. A is correct. Answer is A. This was the only easy question. By chance, I mean, because straight away option A is there. Otherwise, had even this at option A been at third place or fourth place in C or D, I would not have done in even this question. So because I found it in A itself, so I tried it, I did it. Otherwise, if you look at the other questions, definitely not doable. Not at all. The face of the set is telling you that this is not doable. Right? चलिए जी, सो लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड लेट्स टॉक अबाउट अनदर सेट विच वॉज देयर इन जेड 2017. एज आई एम टेलिंग यू गाइज दैट लेट्स नॉट मेक दैम एज द रूल दैट ओके सच काइंड ऑफ सेट्स कम इन जेड. दीज सेट्स आर स्लाइटली लॉन्गर. यू कैन सी दैट बोथ द सेट्स, आई मीन दिस सेट एज वेल एज द प्रीवियस सेट, दे आर स्लाइटली ऑन द लॉन्गर साइड. द रीजन बींग दे वर अपियरिंग इन जेड 2017. ठीक है. So 17 May, it was paper based exam. So even if you have this thing paper based in front of you, you can do something about it. But if this table is there in front of you on a screen, right? And on one side of the screen, there are questions. You must have seen that in CAT as well. And alongside with that, you have to scroll it up and down. Then you have to do the questions. It becomes slightly difficult because of that. Otherwise, the question was easy, right? Just have a look at this question. एक बार इसको पढ़ने की कोशिश करते हैं. I think we'll get an idea by reading this. Abdul has 8 factories with different capacities producing boutique kurtas. In the production process, he incurs raw material cost, selling cost, that is for packaging and transportation, and labor cost. These costs per kurta vary across factories. In all these factories, a worker takes 2 hours to produce a kurta. Profit per kurta is calculated by deducting raw material cost, selling cost, and labor cost from the selling price. So profit is selling price minus raw material minus selling cost minus labor cost. So any other cost can be ignored. So the point is, when I see, look at this equation, profit is equal to selling price minus raw material minus selling cost minus labor cost. This profit is given to us over here. This selling price is given to us over here. Raw material is not given. This selling cost is given to us here. And labor cost is also given. So basically, just by subtracting these, I can calculate the raw material cost as well. So now I have the production capacity. I have the selling price, profit, selling cost, and labor cost. And by subtracting these, I can also calculate the raw material cost. And if I look at these figures, the figures are also, as I told you before as well in the previous class, Figures are all in multiples of 5 or 10, right? Some of them are multiples of 5, except one figure which I see as 68 by factory 4 selling cost per kurta. Otherwise, most of them are multiples of 5 and 10. That makes the question, I mean, doable. That makes the question, I mean, calculations easy. So, probably looks like a easy set, ki should have been done, I suppose. Darshan, there is no damage in leaving the sets. Rather, leaving the sets is a part of your strategy. We all know that in Z, there is a negative marking for leaving the questions as well, but that starts after leaving 8 questions. And then for next 10 questions, there is a negative marking of 1. So after leaving 18 questions, you will have 1 negative. So that's not much. Do not think about it, I would say. What kind of questions are there? Which of the following options is in decreasing order of raw material cost? See, we just talked about this, that we can easily calculate the raw material cost, and he says you have to just put them in decreasing order. We can easily do that. Next, which of the factories listed in the options below has the lowest sales margin? And sales margin, he says, profit per kurta divided by selling price per kurta. So P by SP, lowest kahan par hai? This is P, this is SP. So we have to figure out that in which case this is the lowest. And obviously we have to check only for 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. We don't have to check it for all. So 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have to find this divided by this and it should be the lowest, right? 800 by 5300 and 800 by 5500, obviously it is taken out. 800 by 5500 would be lower than 800 by 5300. 600 by 5400 would be much lower than 800 by 5500. So this is also taken out. So it is not easily eliminate ho rahe hain, some of the options, right? 600 by 5400 is 1 by 9. 500 by 4900 is 1 by 9.8. This is also ruled out. These are the only two options that I need to check a little bit. Though this is also very clear that probably 500 by 4900 would be the smallest. So this means the questions in this case were not difficult. So wahi dekh rahe hain har bar, whether it is Z18, whether it is Z17, whether it is 19, 20. So in all the years, there is at least one DI easy set there. The other one is slightly difficult. But yes, even both can be done. We have not seen a paper in which both the sets are such that they cannot be done. Yes, in this case, it was there in Z17. But as I told you, it was the paper-based set. So therefore, probably it happened. Otherwise, generally, it does not happen like this. Okay, everyone. So that is all about DI of Z that I wanted to discuss with you. And this is very important now that we are doing the Z exam analysis just after the exam. The exam gets over at 12:30. We are bringing you the analysis at 12:45. Yes, we are doing it. And possibly we will also talk about some of the memory based questions in this. So many members from our team are appearing for the exam. And immediately after the exam, you'll get to know that what is going to be the difficulty level and everything. Right. So stay tuned with our channel after either at YouTube or at the GradeUp app. We are also running some free series for that on our app and YouTube channel as well. Some of them are only on app, some of them are on YouTube as well. So Z 2021, how to attempt ZQA that I took a few days back. It's already over, but it will be there in recorded format. Crack arithmetic in 4 sessions. It is still going on. Crack DI, we are doing it right now. Decision making and verbal. So we are having a free series for all of these areas. I mean, in these days only. So just check your GradeUp app and you will find out that what all are going on. Apart from these, we are having these important courses as well. So for non-CAT exams, we are running this course. For Z 2021, decision making course is going on. For GK and current affairs, and for obviously the after exam process, we have a special course for GT, VAT and PI. So you can find all the details on the app once you go through this. And if you are tuned to GradeUp community, obviously you get all the important announcements. There, daily free quizzes would be there, mini mocks, everything would be given to you free on that community, right? GradeUp super subscription. So basically when you take super subscription, so everything else is covered under this. You don't need to take anything extra. So 18 months is the super subscription duration, which is the largest one, mostly for the kids who are preparing for CAT or Z 2021, Z 22 and CAT 21. or 12 months, 6 months, 3 months, that is completely up to you. So once you take 18 months subscription, basically for 18 months, whatever is related to these ambient entrance exams is all yours, whether it is live courses, recorded courses, mock tests, doubt sessions, whatever. So everything would be covered under that. This is our great team of teachers who would be teaching you, right? So along with their percentiles and their experience, you can see that, right? So that's all, guys. All the very best for the exam. This was the last session that we had about DI. I'm sure that you will score good and these sessions would be helpful for you. Go through the QA sessions as well, which I took a few days back. Go through the arithmetic sessions. Anurag sir is taking them. Go through the DM sessions. KD sir is taking them. So just go through these sessions so that you can score well in the exam. Obviously, if you score well, we would be the happiest people on earth, right? Okay, everyone. So thank you very much. Good night now. Good night, everyone.